Karakudi, a favorite South Indian dish. Karam means chili, and the podi made out is called as Karapudi. It's perfect with rice, idlis and dosas. So we're going to take chilies, about 20 in number. The big, long, nice red color dry chilies. Then we're going to take chana dal or yellow gram, 1 cup. Coriander seeds or dhania seeds, 1 cup. This is the seeds from which you get the cilantro or coriander. 6 to 7 strands of curry leaves, washed and dried. 1 teaspoon of jeera, 3/4 cup of tamarind, salt as per your taste. 20 garlic cloves. For people who don't eat garlic, you can ignore that. And 3 teaspoons of oil. First, I'm going to dry roast the coriander seeds. Note, jeera can also be dry roasted, but I prefer to add jeera as it is. If you want more taste, you can dry roast jeera. Coriander seeds will be dry roasted till they turn their color. Nice aroma comes out while roasting the coriander seeds. This is one of the main ingredients used in rasam and sambar. It is very good for digestion. Take 3 teaspoons of oil. Spread it across the pan and then add the urad dal once it is hot. Roast the urad dal and then add the chana dal and roast it. When they slightly start to change the color, that's when you have to add red chilies. Red chilies get roasted faster. This can be stored for 3-4 months, this karapudi. So make sure that your curry leaves do not have any moisture in it. That is this water or something. So when you add these curry leaves, they become folded because they lose the moisture content in it. If there is water, right, the storage of this karapudi will not be for longer. So after washing it, you have to wipe it. Now add tamarind to it. Tamarind, why we are adding here is, instead of directly blending, is tamarind becomes softer and it is easy to blend. You can switch off the stove and add the tamarind. That heat is enough to make it softer. Or you can put it in medium low flame and also do that. Nice aroma comes out actually when you roast these. And then set this aside. Now while blending, note that first you have to blend the coriander seeds. Some people like a fine powdery mixture. Add little of that and then more of coriander and then blend it. Don't add it fully. So blend this. Now add garlic seeds, jeera and salt. Now blend it. It has to become into a coarse powder. Some people like smooth powder also. If you notice, the surface has coarse coriander powder. Now again add this and mix it. Here there is another tip also. You can add a bit of oil so that the powder is nicely embedded. The way to eat karapudi is, put karapudi and then put a small hole inside the karapudi and then pour little of oil or ghee into it and then nicely spread that. And eat it with idli or dosa